Further to that, Victoria's latest flood crisis could affect thousands of people, with the army on standby to help evacuate residents if needed. Flood warnings are already in place for rivers in the northeast and Gippsland, where towns are bracing for a new wave of torrential rain this weekend.
It was another sleepless night in Tully as defiant residents battled the ever-encroaching floodwaters.
We're stiff, our bones ached because we've walked in water all for the last 3 days, but thank God we've got a caravan down the back and we're on high ground down the back.
The Tillets live on one of the tiny town's worst affected streets, where every home has furniture lifted to higher ground.
It's just frustrating. You can't do anything about it. You just got to live with it.
This serious flood threat remains, but so does the community's light-hearted spirit, with residents wading and wheelbarrowing through submerged streets.
While today's break in the weather has been a welcome reprieve, it won't last long, with tomorrow's deluge expected to bring with it up to another 100 millimetres of rain.
We're prepared to stay. We'll do it. We'll get there.
The rain has also taken its toll in the Alpine region. About 30 people, mostly students, were stranded after a landslip at Mount Buffalo. Much of the north and east of the state is now swamped, and the Premier has been briefed on the worst to come.
We may have a 1-in-100-year flood go through Katamatai.
And these events are not over by any means. A very significant rainfall is forecast for the next few days in northern Victoria.
While at Wangaratta, the waiting game has just begun. Tomorrow night's NAB Cup game is still on at this stage, but the Ovens River is rising fast and the local caravan park has been evacuated.
Unfortunately, by about 8 o'clock tonight, we'll be fully underwater for the 7th time in 18 months.
Hermione Kitson, 10 News.
And Hermione joins us live now from the flood zone. Hermione, as we've heard, there's more rain on the way. How are people up there taking that news?
Well, Helen, residents here, today's dry weather has allowed them to take stock and really bolster their efforts against these floods. But with forecast falls of up to 100 millimetres tomorrow, they know they face a huge battle to save their homes from going under. About a half a dozen army trucks have been deployed to this region and they'll be on standby to help with any necessary evacuations. While the SES is really urging people to stay out of floodwaters where possible, as there's already been a number of rescues, and also to stay out of national parks. So it is going to be a tough weekend ahead, Helen, for many, many communities up this side of the state. But the SES and also locals do say they're as prepared as they possibly can be.
That's good news. Thanks, Hermione. Hermione Kitson reporting live there.